Steph Curry and the Warriors next game. I've been looking forward to this for a while now. You know they'll be running and gunning. And Steph's gonna do two or three things that make you wanna stop and stare. But we can't let that distract us. Because if we lose focus for even a second, they'll be up 20. So maybe it's up to me to put on a little show of my own.
Here at the Oracle Arena as the Golden State Warriors look to grab a win in front of the home crowd here.
Ready, gentlemen?
Last game for the Warriors, they pick up the W against the Clippers. And just one look at the score tells you all you need to know. Checked in. Warriors leading by five. So on the floor for Denver. For Reed and Nurkic in the middle. Freak is out there with Moutier, and it's Chandler in at the three slot. Curry's shot is good. Well, you think about Stephen Curry, and your first thought is he's a remarkable three-point shooter. That's right. But he's not just a long-range threat.
Yeah, I see him as a shot maker, one of the league's top mid-range shooters off the pull-up, too, and he's a creative finisher. Floaters and backspin shots, English, high off the glass. Again, the best shot maker, I think, in the history of the game.
He dishes it to Iguodala. Left side, Curry. Rebounded by Fareed.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
Yeah, the half and half balls are going their way, and that's really a function of effort and intensity. You know, the ball doesn't discriminate. Whoever goes and gets it, that's who owns it.
Freak. First personal foul. Team's third.
Green with the ball. He had 10 points in the win against the Clippers. There's the pick. At the elbow, it's Thompson. He's looking for Bogut and finds him. Six on the shot clock. And it's Green missing. The Nuggets trail by seven. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Kevin, I had a chance to catch up with Steve Kerr. I asked him what players he was really eyeing on the scouting report, and he said one that might surprise you, Kenneth Fareed. He said he plays with so much energy and effort. He really sets the bar for the rest of the team. If we can limit his impact on the game, I think it'll really be to our advantage. Guy's an interesting take. We'll see if they can slow his roll.
Always great to hear from you, Doris. Stolen by Thompson. An even three-on-three break. Bogut kicks to Green. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. And when you look at Draymond Green, he's not a guy who will wow you with his numbers or his athleticism, Clark. He brings a lot of intangibles, though. And I remember talking early in his career with Tom Izzo up at Michigan State saying those exact things that he gives you so much more than just what you see.
And his current coach and our former partner, Steve Kerr, raves about him. He's the heart and soul of the Warriors, in Steve's words.
Now here's Freak, D right on him. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And you can tell he's hungry, because that's how you eat away at a lead right there. Make some highlight reel plays and shake that defense up.
Well, Greg, you're right. Not all 2 points are the same. Not when they come on a stuff like that one.
Well, I like the craftiness in this game. I mean, he can distribute or he can attack the basket, just like we saw right there.
You know, you talk about Green's enthusiasm for the game. He's constantly talking, whether defensively or even in an opponent's ear. He's a vocal presence. And also another example of how a guy can make an impact without necessarily having it show up in the stat sheet. Just lazy defense on the glass there.
Well, nobody boxed out. Nobody put a body on anybody else. Things like that not only drive the coach crazy, that stuff gets under my skin.
Chance here to check out some stats on Steph Curry. Great showing for him last season. First in free throw percentage, third in three-point field goal percentage, and he was also one of the league's most aggressive ball-hawking defenders, finishing top five in steals.
And you know, as you said, Greg, fantastic at the free throw line last year. That's a tremendous asset for any team.
Spates checked in for the Warriors. J.J. Hickson, he's checked in for Denver. Molinari comes in for Wilson Chandler. Now here's Freak. He's covered by Thompson. Here's Hickson. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops.
And also, don't discount his leadership. Draymond Green's been a vocal leader his entire career. Even as a rookie, he wasn't afraid to challenge his teammates. And that competitive spirit, guys, can be contagious.
Here's Freak. To the middle. Moutier pass to Hickson. 9 feet out. The shot no good. And it's the Warriors taking it the other way. And going against Denver, their first meeting of the season.
And they didn't have much of a problem with these guys last season. And quite frankly, you wouldn't expect them to.
Yeah, you know, these are two teams clearly on opposite ends of the continuum in this conference. I mean, this is a team they rightly feel they can beat every time they take the court with them.
And it's Freak missing. Warriors leading by 10. A shot by Thompson and no one's around. That falls. Nice feed that time from Andre Iguodala.
How about the start that they've gotten off to here? Huge lead, and we're still in the first quarter.
And guys, it hasn't just been the scoring. I mean, they're playing tremendous defense, too.
Freak dishes to Moutier. Plays it up and banks it in.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
They double-team Kerr. Fareed against Green. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
And Draymond Green, guys, has won at every level. I mean, led Saginaw High School to two consecutive state championships at Michigan State, two trips to the Final Four, and now making noise with the Warriors. It's clear this guy's a winner.
Catching up on the changes for Golden State. Barnes, he's checked in for Iguodala. Barbosa comes in for Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Steph Curry. Arthur sets the pick for Nelson. Pass to Arthur. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in. Arthur's got it back down to within single digits for the Nuggets. And here's a little known fact, Clark. Only three players have recorded at least two triple-doubles in the NCAA tournament. They are Oscar Robertson, Magic Johnson, and Draymond Green.
That's some elite company for Draymond Green. He's a hard worker, a guy you love if he's on your team. He can be an irritant if he's not with you, but continues to improve and prove his doubters wrong.
Nelson kicks to Arthur, and it's sent back by Spates. Barnes against Gallinari. Poked away. Pass to Green. Down low. And it's blocked. Here's Arthur. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
And really, the Warriors had an amazing regular season last year. Just from a historical standpoint, it was one of the best ever.
And for the Warriors last year, they would end the season with 67 wins. That number, Clark, tying for the sixth best win total in NBA history.
And my guess is only a few people saw it coming. I mean, and as the season wore on, it became more and more apparent that the Warriors were for real, but it took a while for people to accept that fact.
Here is the 2K leaderboard with last season's top passing teams. The Warriors, number one.
These guys move the ball offensively was really a joy to watch. Great teamwork and unselfishness, and that's why we saw those great assist numbers a season ago.
Freak kicks to Hixon. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. Hixon, a screen on Barbosa. Freak passes to Hixon, and he comes off the screen and slams it through.
Now that's finishing your work right there.
Powerful two-hand jam, you're right.
And I tell you what, if he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will start shrinking even further.
Green, no luck.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Gallinari wide open, connects from three-point range. Gallinari's got himself on the board with three there. Warriors leading by six. Livingston dishes to Barnes. Green kicks to Barbosa. And that'll be Golden State as it goes out of bounds. Warriors retain possession.
And you can tell that pass just hung in the air for a long time.
Yeah, exactly. Long enough for him to get a hand on it and knock it out of play.
A minute 42 left here in the opening quarter. Green passes to Spates. Just five on the clock. Here's Livingston. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. They put up a nice win against Utah last time out.
And it goes back to what's been their strength, really, on the interior. From a defensive standpoint, they just defended the rim as well as you could.
Yeah, I thought it was really impressive the way they did it, guys. They were alert, they were active, they were aware, and their reaction to shots was outstanding.
The three from Barnes. No luck. Now Denver takes it the other way. Now Freak. Gallinari, the open look. Barnes grabs the miss.
They've got a narrow edge here in rebounding early on. You wonder how much that'll play going forward.
Yeah, it's a game of inches in every play.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
The Nuggets trail by seven. Kicks it to Gallinari. Now here's Freak, covered by Barbosa. Back to Gallinari. For the three, another three for Denver.
The rapid-fire threes coming from everywhere.
Yeah, I'm not sure of the quality of that three-point shot attempt right there. Going at it the way they did, but it all worked out for them.
The high post shot. Spates kicks to Livingston. The drive by Green, and it's good. Assisting on the play was Livingston. Green's got five. 11 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Nelson dishes to Freak. Fader on the way. No good on that last second attempt there. And Steph Curry, a player within the gym range. He told us about his comfort stretching the floor.
Anywhere 5-6 feet outside that three-point line, if I have a dribble, if I catch and shoot, if I have a good look, you know, I think Coach allowed me to take that shot. And it's tough to guard, especially when you see a couple go in. that basket gets a lot bigger.
I was going to say, Greg, how big must that be? The Warriors with some changes. Spates comes in for Andrew Bogut, and it's Green in for Andre Iguodala. So on the floor for Denver, Freak in at shooting guard. Kenneth Faried is out there with Arthur. Then it's Moutier, and it's Hickson in at the center. Hickson a screen. Faried setting the pick for Moutier.
Whoa! And it was the screen there, guys, that freed him up as he ran his man into it.
And then it was all acceleration, GA, to the bucket right after that.
Almost a backboard breaker.
And that last replay courtesy of Kia. They double-team Kerr. Here's Spates. And there are the Warriors now with another bucket.
And that kind of sums up the defensive effort we've seen here tonight, guys.
The Nuggets trail by 15. Freak passes to Hickson, and the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Hickson's got six.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
And Clark, it's a strategy that has served them well during the course of this first half.
Thompson outside, fires top of the key. The shot no good. Great T that time from Freak.
And what a first year it was for Steve Kerr and the Warriors. It was the best debut as a new coach ever. 67 wins. He also established a franchise win total in his first year.
Steph Curry, good. And here's Moutier. He had 19 points in the win against Utah.
And also, he competed on the backboards. That also had a lot to do with the game.
So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
Yeah, the defender all over him.
Greg, he got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
And we'll get a look at how the hustle stat game has been going for the Warriors.
Well, I think the defensive aggressiveness on display here has caught him off guard, playing airtight defense and coming up with the steals.
And also, how about how well they defended the rim, not just blocking shots, but also altering them here in this first half.
Defensively, they just weren't there. I mean, that's a freebie. Should have been 2 points.
Arthur kicks to Freak. Down low, Hickson. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Yeah, he earned that one. I mean, taking the hit and still able to get that one to go down.
Incredible, incredible body control right there. Don't know how he was able to get that one to go, but it sure was a thing of beauty to watch.
And just as J.J. Hickson seemed to be finding some rhythm in his career, Clark, last season happened. His production dropped like a rock.
Yeah, you know, Kevin, after two straight years where he was starting, last season he was asked to come off the bench. And for J.J. Hickson, that just did not seem to be a good fit.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
Here's Moutier. That ball is in the basket. Now he's shot six and made three of them.
Boy, after struggling in the first quarter, he's come alive here in the second.
And getting back to J.J. Hickson, he's forever had the size and strength to get it done. His problems have always been that lack of discipline and an unrefined set of tools. I mean, unfortunately, last season highlighted those flaws.
Now here's Freak.
Move the ball. It's sticking too much.
Out to the wing. Here's Faried. The shot misses. The Warriors go the other way with it.
Talking about Hickson, every time you count him out, he surprises you with a streak of inspired play. Then every time you count him back in, he puts up a dud. Hard guy to figure out right now.
Over in the corner, Moutier. The pass to Freak. Clock at six. The Nuggets need to get a shot off here. Offensive rebound. Warriors leading by 12. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
And some of Harrison Barnes' teammates have referred to him as the center.
And so that brings the first half to a close. Warriors
Well, Jameer, as you come out after the halftime, what do you think is going to be the most important thing for the team to do?
We have to continue to get stops and offensively take care of the ball, myself in particular. Careless turnovers shouldn't happen, and, you know, it's part of the game, but I just have to value the ball a little more.
Jameer, thank you. Always thinking like a point guard, guys.
Thank you, Dort.
Okay, guys, let's talk about that first half. We've given this crowd way too much to cheer about. The second half is going to be played on our terms. You got me? The key phrase for us in the second half is ball security. Keep the turnovers down. Make smart passes and protect the ball. We haven't done that. Let's also make sure we keep our heads on straight. Nobody likes to be in the position we're in right now, but we can't lose our cool. And let's not lean too much on the fast break in the second half. Get things set up when we can. The points will come fast enough. Don't worry. We've got an uphill battle on our hands, no doubt about it. I don't want to catch you guys looking at the scoreboard. All we can do is play our game.
Oracle Arena, let's keep it going.
All right, the second half beginning in just a moment.
How about Steph?
And the Warriors with some changes. Harrison Barnes, he's checked in for Draymond Green. Barbosa comes in for Klay Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Steph Curry. Iguodala, the three, with Barnes, the stretch four. Livingston is out there with Barbosa, and it's Bogut in at the five. That's the Warriors' five. Now here's Freak. Tight defense on him. He feeds it to Nelson. From the baseline. And there's Gallinari on the assist by Nelson. Gallinari's got his third basket of the night right there. Barbosa with it. From deep. And it would have counted had it fallen, but it's offline. And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. The Warriors shooting 53% from the floor. They're locked in. And Denver will start the fourth quarter with Freak. He's in at point guard. Arthur out there with Laverne. Then it's Johnson.
You know, something that's floating around in the sports world and in the NBA is reseeding after the playoffs start. And for those of you who may not understand the situation, it's simply saying that no matter what, it would play the lower seeded team, however you get to those numbers.
Here's Livingston. And it's Freak with the rebound. Freak's got five rebounds tonight. A three ball. That one falls. Coming off the Johnson feed. Freak's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Nuggets. And with that whole concept of playoff reseeding, so often we'll see a second or third seed team get a sixth or seventh seed team in the second round. Meanwhile, Greg, the top seed plays the fourth seed no matter what. And some changes here for the Warriors. Barnes, he's checked in for Draymond Green. Klay Thompson comes in for Andre Iguodala. And Curry subbed in for Sean Livingston. And then for Denver, J.J. Hickson, he's checked in for Chandler. Freak comes in for Randy Foy. And Jameer Nelson is subbed in for Moutier. The shot by Hickson, no good.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Count that one. And now that's 35 points for Steph Curry.
A very hot shooting second half has seen them bring that field goal percentage way up.
Yeah, and they're cruising right now, looking to add to the lead.
Nurkic setting the pick for Freak. The dish to Nurkic, the 10-footer. Rebound Bogut. Bogut's got six rebounds in the game.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. And you can safely say mission accomplished now for the Warriors.
You're right, Steve. It was a standout performance across the board. They were just, at times, hard to seem toying with.
Yeah, like watching a cat play with a mouse, Kevin. Yeah. But honestly, they were able to do more or less whatever they wanted to do.
And it'll mark their fourth win on the year. Actually, their fifth win on the year.
And they'll take the win tonight, setting the tone in the first matchup of this four-game season series.
And it will be a fight, Greg. When you see an opponent that many times, it's inevitable that those games take on a little extra added meaning to the play.
And when you look back at this one, what an amazing performance this was for Curry. He was extremely efficient offensively, got good looks, and really knocked down big shots all game long.
Catching up on the changes for Golden State. Azili's check in for Bogut. McAdoo comes in for Klay Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Curry. Denver with a tough year last season. A lot of losses for them on the road as they would go, like Clark, only 11-30 away from the Mile High City.
Yeah, and Kevin, they ended the season on a five-game road losing streak as well. I mean, they had mostly given up at that point as they had tried to develop young players, and it just kind of blew up on them down the stretch.
A big problem for the Nuggets last year is that they just couldn't hit shots away from home. I mean, they finished in the bottom five in terms of field goal percentage on the road.
Hey, I've got one more note on the Nuggets and the road. I mean, when you shoot as poorly as they did, as you mentioned, you start to lose some confidence and second-guess things. It's a lot harder to fight through shooting slumps like that in somebody else's building, no doubt.
And stolen by Freak. And here we go. Fast break. Freak's got it. Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. Barnes dishes to Livingston. And the foul called on Freak. That's his third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for two.
Fouling like that isn't how you get back in the game.
Looks to me like just a frustration foul. It really kind of sums up the game they're having in general.
So we see the Warriors taking the game here.
Yes, Kevin, thank you. I'm with Klay Thompson. You were all over the place tonight, getting it done for your team. How do you prepare for this next game?
It's tough, but, you know, for me, I got fresh young legs, not playing heavy minutes, so I'm excited. And they got us at their place, but, you know, we're looking for redemption.
Thank you, Klay. We so
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Thank you, Kevin, and now we get a chance to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Stephen Curry.
I don't know if there's a fan base that loves their star more than this crowd. He's jealous, and he feeds off that support. Once they got behind him, he became unstoppable, man!
I will say this about Steph Curry. There is no player in the league more capable of single-handedly taking over a ball game than he is. What I mean is, Steph Curry's hot is hotter than anyone else is hot. He can beat you with his feet, his mind, his shot. The only thing you can be sure of is that he will beat you.
And that brings us to the end of our broadcast for this evening. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our
What a life, eh, Freak? One minute you're playing 21 and horse on the courts in Harlem, and the next moment you're in the showroom configuring the gunmetal and graphite exterior of your luxury car and your iPad mini. Oh, I bet you get a crazy crowd when you drive that car around the block in the old neighborhood, huh?
Yeah, living the dream. Mad pandemonium. But folks from back around the way are real proud of me.
Yeah, I hear you. Local kid makes good. Mm-hmm. You know, it kind of reminds me of when I took my tech stock public and I rang the New York Stock Exchange bell and my mom's friends called her up and said, Maggie, is that your son on Bloomberg News this morning ringing the bell? And my mom says, yes, sirree, Bob, it was him. That was a great moment, Freak. And you know, our lives are like a pearl necklace of great moments, all strung together with the finest silk thread of memories. And we have to be very careful how we cultivate those pearls and we thread that necklace.
Does this meeting by any chance have to do with Vic Van Leer?
I grew up in the burbs, Freak. I wasn't poor, upper middle class, comfortable. My daddy worked as an accountant for one of the largest insurance firms in the country. Smart with his money. Mom didn't have to work. I went to boarding school. And then my dad died of a heart attack when I was a freshman at MIT. I was a movie geek, wanted to be a civil engineer, but I made my fortune by becoming a hybrid of both those interests. My dad didn't want me to be an accountant. Oh, listen to this. My best friend was a guy named Isidore. Yeah, we called him Izzy. He was one of the smartest human beings I have ever met in my life. I mean, Izzy was taking second year college calculus courses as a high school sophomore, right? Straight A student, full ride to MIT. Izzy had the world at his fingertips. But he was always looking for trouble, and trouble found him. He ran with the wrong crowd. And when we got to MIT, he got this great job working for a financial consulting firm in Boston. Mm. But every weekend, he would fly to Vegas. You see, Izzy had a system for counting cards in Vegas that had the big casinos on the strip. Oh, stymied! He would come back to MIT with suitcases filled with $200,000 in cold cash.
What?
Yeah.
So your man Izzy was getting hit off like that?
Like a fat rat in a cheddar cheese factory, Freak.
Okay, so what happened to this dude Izzy? Because he's dope.
No, not dope. Dead. After he'd been missing for 3 weeks, the Nevada State Police never found hide nor hair of Isidore. And our friendship took a hit when he asked me to hang out with him in Vegas, and I said I wouldn't do it because I knew he was on a dark and twisted path in his life. And yes, yes, he was my dude. But no way was I gonna throw my life away trying to show my loyalty to a guy who really and truly didn't understand what loyalty was all about.
So this meeting is about Vic.
Correctamente.
Okay, well, sir, Vic isn't Izzy.
And why's that, Freak?
Well, for one thing, you and your dead friend Izzy didn't grow up poor. Me and Vic grew up in a neighborhood where we had to look over our shoulder every 2 seconds to make sure nobody was going to walk up on us and rob us.
True. Izzy and I did not grow up in the hood. But we, like you, thankfully grew up in a two-parent household. But even that wasn't enough for Izzy. He wasn't satisfied. He was always looking for a five-alarm fire when he already had the warmth and comfort of a loving family. This is not about class warfare, Freak. This is about the consequences of making bad choices and risking it all when you feel like you have nothing to lose.
Vic is like a brother to me, sir.
But you shouldn't be Brother Vic's keeper, Freak. Would a brother go looking for trouble and put your career and your livelihood at risk by getting into fights at nightclubs and seedy after-hour joints and then scream to the media, yeah, it's all good, I'm an FOF, friend of Freak. It's all misunderstanding. Y'all be haters, don't hate my game. I don't think a brother would do that to someone they really cared about, but a guy who looked at you like a meal ticket would.
No. So you don't understand Vic.
Really? I don't understand.
No.
Look, man, It was a misunderstanding with the guy in the next VIP booth. His honey started flirting with me. So naturally, I started flirting back. Next thing I know, Captain Cornball's off my grill piece beefing. Next thing he know, he got a two-piece and a biscuit under his left eye. Hey, nah, I don't know who hit him. And it damn sure wasn't me. Hey, Captain Cornball's mad because I'm an F-O-F, friend of freak. Hey, but check this out, though. He needs to train that hottie before he leave the house, though. Yo, he's hotties ain't loyal, man.
What's there to understand? Are you freaking blind? You know, I just want to know, how much did you pay your lawyers to make all this go away?
Almost $100,000.
Excuse me, son, I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you.
I said I paid almost $100,000.
Exactly. And if you keep riding shotgun with Vic, you're going to go broke. Quick, fast, and in a hurry.
Look, Vic is my friend, and I grew up with him. How many times I got to tell you, sir?
Freak, this is not a request. I am not asking you to do this. I am telling you to do this. And the first order of business is that Mr. Vic Van Leer is banned from traveling with you on the road. Vic is banned from the locker room. And Vic is banned from this arena. And if I catch this guy, Vic, in or anywhere near the facilities, Mr. Vic Van Leer will be arrested for trespassing.
Are you serious, sir?
Brother, I'm as serious as cancer. We all know that can be deadly.
You know, when me and Vic were kids, playing summer tournaments at the Dome, we always imagined making it to the pros, right? And after the crowds left, just a streetlight was on the court, like 11:30, 12 midnight, even 1 in the morning sometimes. We used to practice player introductions, running on the court, giving dap, high-fiving the teammates. Vic, he would act as an announcer. You know, he would introduce me, announce my name on a loudspeaker, and the Jumbotron would flash my image like a little guy dressed in long shorts and a jersey. And now, fresh off his 3-game, 62-point scoring streak, the youngest player to ever do so in NBA history, Frequency Vibrations! So me and Vic were sitting in those empty bleachers at the Dome and dreamed like nobody's business. And now I'm living a dream. For real. And in so many ways, Vic was part of that.
Please, listen to me. I mean, I know this guy's your dude from way back.
Me and Vic go way back, like the front seats of a 67 Cadillac.
That's good. We go way back. Did you say front seats?
Front seats of a 67 Cadillac.
We go way back, like the front seats of a 67 Cadillac. Well, do you have any crickets? I'm going to be the hit once again at Herbie Island, Sun Valley Shindig, because my fellow billionaires love it when I walk and talk that talk.
So that almost sounds...
No, let me tell you exactly what it sounds like. I respect, admire, and most importantly, love you as a human being and a role model. But I pay you a lot. And I mean, I pay you a lot of money to play for my team. And I am in this game to win it. And you can't win it with an albatross around your neck like Vic. So Vic is done. History. And here's some more lingo that I picked up from a former megastar who used to play for me several seasons ago. Thought I would never release him until I did. And now he's the sixth man on a struggling team in Venice. And yeah, I'm talking Venice with the canals and the gondolas and Harry's Bar, not the street ballers next to the fortune tellers on the beach in Cali. This guy used to tell me when he thought there was a player destroying our team, don't be a hero, cut that zero. And that is what I am telling you about Vic, freak. Don't be a hero, cut that zero. The only thing Vic brings into your life is headache. an unwanted and unnecessary negative attention, and it will begin to affect your mindset. And when it affects your mindset, it's gonna affect your play. And when it affects your play, it's gonna affect my team. And when it affects my team, it's gonna affect my money. And if it affects my money, Google Translate will become your new freaking friend. I want a championship ring, Freak, and I want you to help me get that ring. And banners, after banners, hanging from the rafters in this arena. So, Freak, hear me clearly and hear me good. V-G-G Vic gotta go! Handle your business. And remember, that contract you signed contains a morality clause, a very important clause that revolves around your conduct on and off the court and how it can negatively impact my team. Now, I don't want you to have to learn Italian or Croatian as a second language. And hey, playing pro ball overseas, there's nothing wrong with that. But the arenas are nothing like this, nor will the money be the same. And on top of all of that, this is the U.S. of A., the greatest freaking country in the world. Ask yourself, is Vic worth all that? Think about it. Think long, think wrong.
Tell you about Vic. He has his bad rap. It's not, and I understand some of his judgments might shadow his actual character. He's not that at all. Man, Vic, let me tell you something. We actually, like, we have love for each other. We're brothers. Blood couldn't make us any closer at all. I mean, he has so much loyalty to me and to my family. You could see even Cece, you know, has issues with him, but he still loves her. He still loves her.